A very warm greetings to all. I, Priyanka Agarwal, welcomes you all in our new series of income tax, that is our new head of income from house property. So let's understand what is property. So property consists of any building or land accessories of which the assessee is the owner and which is not used for purposes of assessor's business or profession. Matlab, कोई भी ऐसा बिल्डिंग या उस बिल्डिंग के आसपास की जमीन जो असेसी ने अपने बिजनेस या प्रोफेशन के लिए यूज ना कर रखी हो, उसे या तो फर्दर आगे रेंट पे दे रखा हो या फिर अपने ओन रेजिडेंशियल पर्पस के लिए यूज किया जा रहा हो, तो वो इज हेड दैट इज इनकम फ्रॉम हाउस प्रॉपर्टी के अंडर प्रॉपर्टी कही जाएगी. सो लेट सी व्हाट इज द बेसिस ऑफ चार्ज. So in this chapter, we have to calculate or we have to examine the annual value of the property. So the basis of calculation income from house property is the annual value. This is the inherent capacity of the property to earn income. The charge is not because of the receipt of any income, but is on the inherent potential of the house property to generate income. Means, उस हाउस प्रॉपर्टी की जो भी इनहेरेंट कैपेसिटी होगी, जो भी उसमें पोटेंशियल होगा एटलीस्ट इनकम अर्न करने का, वही उसका एनुअल वैल्यू कहलाएगा. एनुअल वैल्यू इज नॉट कंपल्सरी, वुड बी द म्यूनिसिपल वैल्यू रेंट या फिर फेयर रेंटल वैल्यू और द एक्चुअल रेंट वी आर रिसीविंग फ्रॉम अवर हाउस प्रॉपर्टी. सो बेसिकली इट इज द इनहेरेंट कैपेसिटी और वी कैन ऑल्सो से दैट इट इज द नोशनल वैल्यू ऑफ द हाउस प्रॉपर्टी. Now, conditions to be fulfilled for property income to be taxable under this head. So let's see. The property must consist of building and land appurtenant thereto. Second, incomplete building is not treated as building. Then, the Act recognizes certain buildings even without roof, like we all know, stadium, swimming pool. They don't have roof, but we don't say that it is the incomplete building. So, such buildings are also called as the house property and the income generated from these house property also taxable. Then, the assessee must be the owner of such house property. Next, the property may be used for any purpose but should not be used by the owner for the purpose of any business or profession of its own. If it is so, so that income will be calculated under the head business and profession, not in the head house property. So, कोई भी ऐसी building जो assessee ने अपने लिए use करी है, residential purpose के लिए use करी है, या फिर उसे आगे let out किया है, तो वो आप यहाँ पे calculate करेंगे. उस building के लिए हमें annual value calculate करनी होगी और वहीं से हमें इसकी tax liability पता चलेगी. अगर कोई building किसी एसएससी ने अपने बिजनेस और प्रोफेशन के लिए यूज कर रखी है, तो उस बिल्डिंग से जो भी अर्निंग होगी वो आपके बिजनेस और प्रोफेशन हेड के अंदर कैलकुलेट होगी, ना कि इनकम फ्रॉम द हाउस प्रॉपर्टी हेड के अंदर. नाउ अवर नेक्स्ट इज व्हेन इनकम फ्रॉम हाउस प्रॉपर्टी इज नॉट चार्ज टू टैक्स. सो इन द फॉलोइंग केसेस इनकम फ्रॉम प्रॉपर्टी इज नॉट चार्ज टू टैक्स. फर्स्ट इज rent from a vacant plot is not an income from the house property, but it is taxable under business and profession. Then, income from any farmhouse forming part of agricultural income. हम पहले भी इसे discuss कर चुके हैं, like agricultural income या farmhouse या कोई भी ऐसी building जो हमने आगे farmhouse में रखी हो या फिर हम warehouse में use कर रहे हो, so वो आपकी agricultural income में calculate होगी, ना कि आपकी house property. The next is earning from a paying guest accommodation. And when a club provides accommodation to its members. Now, let's understand the one of the most and basic concept of this house property chapter, that is annual value. Hum sirf sabhi numericals mein ya theories mein basic aapka annual value rahega. Annual value hume calculate to karna hoga. तो सबसे पहले देखते हैं ये एनुअल वैल्यू है क्या. तो एज पर सेक्शन 23(1)(a) द एनुअल वैल्यू ऑफ एनी प्रॉपर्टी shall be the sum for which the property might reasonably be accepted to be let from 1 year, year to year. It may neither be the actual rent derived nor the municipal valuation of the property. It is something like notional rent, which could have been derived had the property been. अगर आपके पास प्रॉपर्टी है तो कुछ ना कुछ उसका पोटेंशियल होगा कि अगर आप उसे लेट आउट करोगे तो इतना वो अर्न करके आपको दे सकती है, वही उसकी एनुअल वैल्यू है. लेकिन जरूरी नहीं है कि ये एनुअल वैल्यू उसकी एक्चुअल पोटेंशियल या एक्चुअल रिसीविंग है या फिर उसकी म्यूनिसिपल वैल्यूएशन है. सो इसे कैलकुलेट किया कैसे जाता है, सो लेट्स सी कैलकुलेट के लिए हमें क्या क्या चीजें करनी होंगी या किन फैक्टर्स पे हम ध्यान रखेंगे. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल जो फैक्टर्स हैं देखने के लिए या जिन जब हम एनुअल वैल्यू कैलकुलेट करेंगे हाउस प्रॉपर्टी की, सो वी हैव टू गो थ्रू 4 मेन फैक्टर्स. दे आर एक्चुअल रेंट, म्यूनिसिपल वैल्यू, फेयर रेंटल वैल्यू एंड स्टैंडर्ड रेंट. इन ऑल क्वेश्चंस और इन ऑल मैनर्स वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एंड वी हैव टू गो थ्रू दीज 4 वैल्यूज ऑफ द हाउस प्रॉपर्टी. So let understood one by one each and everything. So first is actual rent received या फिर receivable. तो जब भी हम कोई property let out कर रहे होंगे या अगर हमने own अपने purpose के लिए ही use करी है तो कुछ ना कुछ उसका potential होगा कि what is the actual rent that building can be arrived, can be raised या फिर is raising. So that is the actual rental value. Then municipal value, it is the value of a property that the municipal authorities of city or town assigned to a particular property. जो भी उस एरिया की म्यूनिसिपैलिटी रहेगी वो कुछ ना कुछ एक वैल्यू, म्यूनिसिपल वैल्यू फिक्स करके रखते हैं सर्टेन सिटी की, टाउन की, तो वही उस प्रॉपर्टी की म्यूनिसिपल वैल्यू हो जाएगी. Then next is fair rental value. Fair rental value is also called as market value. So it refers to the market rent or rent for the similar property in same locality or in the nearby localities. Then next is standard rent, and it is the maximum rent of the property which a person can receive from his tenant. But if there is RCA, RCA means Rent Controlling Act. If in that area RCA is applicable, only then we have to calculate the standard rent of the property, or then we will have the maximum rental value of the property. Otherwise, we will skip this step. So there are 4 basic terms when we are going to the annual value. First is actual rent, second municipal value, third is your fair rental value, and fourth one is standard rent. Now let's see what is the basic formula to calculate annual value. So here is the formula to calculate gross annual value of the property. So first of all, we have to calculate expected rent of the property. But how we will calculate expected rent? So expected rent will be calculated by the way we have to compare municipal rental value of the property with fair rental value. And whichever is higher in both terms, we will take further. And then we will compare the higher term with the standard rent. And whatever is the lower term, we will take next. And that lower rent will be called as expected rent. After that, we will compare expected rent with actual rent. And we will take the higher rent, and that higher rent will be called as gross annual value. This is the basic formula to calculate gross annual value. Means सबसे पहले हमें expected rent calculate करना है. Expected rent कैसे calculate हो जाएगा? Like अभी मैंने explain किया है the 4 terms, but उन 4 terms को हम एक sequence में लिखते हैं. Sequence क्या है? First of all, we will write municipal rent. Then fair rental value, then standard rent, and fourth is your actual rent. First of all, we will compare municipal rental value with fair rental value. In dono mein jo bhi higher term hogi, we will take that further. Aur us higher term ko fir hum compare kar lenge with standard rent. अब इन दोनों में जो भी लोअर टर्म होगी उसे हम कहते हैं एक्सपेक्टेड रेंट, और उस एक्सपेक्टेड रेंट को हम कंपेयर करेंगे एक्चुअल रेंटल वैल्यू से, और इन दोनों में जो हायर टर्म होगी वो हमारा क्या हो जाएगा, ग्रॉस एनुअल वैल्यू ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी। अब ग्रॉस एनुअल वैल्यू तो निकल गया, बट हाउ वी विल कैलकुलेट नेट एनुअल वैल्यू? सो ग्रॉस माइनस टैक्सेस, टैक्सेस मींस म्युनिसिपैलिटी टैक्सेस, दैट विल बी इज इक्वल टू अवर नेट एनुअल वैल्यू। बट देयर आर सम केसेस आल्सो, सो लेट अंडरस्टैंड दैट केसेस आल्सो। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, कंप्यूटेशन ऑफ एनुअल वैल्यू, व्हेन वी आर कैलकुलेटिंग एनुअल वैल्यू इन द केस ऑफ सेल्फ ऑक्युपाइड हाउस, इफ देयर इज अ असेसी हु इज हैविंग ओनली वन सेल्फ ऑक्युपाइड हाउस, सो द एनुअल वैल्यू बी ऑलवेज जीरो। बट व्हेन द असेसी इज हैविंग मोर देन वन हाउस एंड देन वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एनुअल वैल्यू, so how we will calculate it, so here is the formula. Just we have to be remind that when we are calculating annual value for the self occupied house, we don't take the fourth term, that is our actual rental value ya fir actual rent received. Other than that all method is there or everything is similar. Like first of all, we will calculate municipal rental value with fair rental value. Whichever is higher, we will compare that higher amount with standard rent. And whatever is the lower amount, we will take that amount as the annual value. But it is in the case when there is RCA. As I already told, when there is RCA, RCA means Rent Controlling Act. If in that society or in that area RCA is applicable, we will take standard rent. If there is not RCA, RCA is not implemented, so we will don't take our standard rent. Then what is the calculation? Then we will just compare municipal rental value with fair rental value, and whatever is the higher amount, that will become our annual rental value. So it is the case when we are calculating annual value in the case of self-occupied house. Now, next is when we have to calculate annual value in case of let out house property. So again, there may be two cases, when RCA is implemented and when there is no RCA. So how we will calculate? The process is again same. We have to calculate, or first of all we have to check what is the expected rent. And as I earlier told you, how we will calculate expected rent, municipal rental value will be compared with fair rental value. The higher term will be compared with standard rental value. And then the lower term will be termed as expected rent. And that lower value will be compared with again actual rental value. And then we will take the higher amount, and that higher amount will be called as annual value. But just one thing we have to take in mind, then when there is no RCA, we will don't take standard rent. So here are the two main cases of this, of the house property. In next series or in next video, we will do some numerical portion also. So I think some basic concept of income from house property is clear to all. Just keep in mind, when we are talking about income from house property, we will go through only one term, that is annual value, most important term, that is the annual value. We have to check the annual value of the property. So I just told you how we will calculate annual value for the different cases when we have occupied the house for self residential purpose or when we let it out. So in next series I will tell you, or I will explain you with the examples, with the numerical examples. So for this time, I think it is sufficient. So keep learning and all the best.